Okay, let's start. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Oops. How are you doing, dude? Bisa lihat slide saya kan ya. So, suara saya kedengeran kan?
Dengar, Pak.
Dengar.
Okay. Cool. All right. So, I think this is the last meeting for our last chapter. It's about the explanation text. Jadi ini meeting terakhir untuk materi tentang explanation text-nya. Previously, we talked about the explanation text, what it is, and we see the examples of the explanation text. And for this meeting, I'm going to show you actually about, well, this actually not part of your lesson. It's just an additional stuff, so, just, so it's like the enrichment for you. I'd like to show you the sample of the IELTS Task Writing 1. So first, I'd like to tell you about what is IELTS, by the way. So IELTS is one of type of English proficiency tests. If you are willing to study abroad, you're gonna need either TOEFL or IELTS or SAT. Jadi bisa pakai IELTS, SAT, atau TOEFL kalau untuk mau sekolah luar negeri biasanya. Ini TOEFL, IBT, or IELTS. Nah, in both TOEFL and IELTS, both a proficiency test, ini yang paling umum ya, yang paling common for Indonesia. And actually, you still have TOEIC and stuff, ada CAE dan sebagainya. But paling umum di Indonesia ada TOEFL dan IELTS. In every single test, one of the assessment you have is writing assessment. Jadi kalian akan diminta untuk menulis teks, essay, dalam 200-250 kata, 100-250 kata. It depends on the task, by the way. Nah, and then I check some of the assignments or assessment in each proficiency test, and I think what relates to you to our topic about the explanation test is the IELTS Task 1. Now, IELTS Task 1, IELTS untuk writing itu ada Task 1 and Task 2. The Task 1 biasanya it talks about the graphic chart, pie chart, table and stuff. Jadi biasanya di Task 1 itu berhubungan dengan menjelaskan tabel, gambar, grafik, chart, dan sebagainya. Nah, yang kita bicaranya adalah satu dari beberapa tugas dari IELTS-nya di task 1. And then nanti task 2, it's actually related to the exposition text, karena memberikan pendapat di teksnya, atau juga berhubungan dengan discussion text. It's actually, you actually have the discussion text, tapi I think we're gonna talk about it later on. Yang seperti itu. So what we learn actually in the class about the text, how to write the text, is related to your practical and technical skills in the English proficiency test if you are willing to take it in the future. Nah, so therefore the learning objectives today is I want to show you about the IELTS Task 1 and how to write it. And then the second is I expect you have the idea on how to write it. And at the end, you can produce one text. Jadi ini juga mungkin bisa jadi referensi kalian untuk buat tugasnya yang saya minta kemarin. Nah, what's the difference then between the explanation text you have and with the IELTS Task 1 writing practice about the process The difference is that, yang paling major difference-nya adalah, when you talk about the explanation text, you need to have the technical terms. Jadi kalau the explanation text itu perlu ada technical terms-nya. So for example, when you talk about metamorphosis misalnya yang kalian bicarain, yang kalian tulis, then you need to have like some technical terms yang berkaitan dengan topiknya metamorfosis. Nah, but for the writing practice test in IELTS, what you're gonna need is, well, because it's only about like 20 minutes writing for the test, you don't need to have the technical terms. It's just about how you organize your idea and present your idea based on your interpretation of the text and the picture or table or chart you have. Jadi itu sih sebenarnya beda yang paling dasarnya yang sisa saya lihat and very simple to explain. Okay, let's move on. Oh, ini nggak nampak ya. Nah, this is one of the example of the IELTS writing one, task one for the describing a process. Nah, nanti tugasnya itu nanti biasanya ada dikasih gambar proses seperti ini. Kemudian, wait a second. Yeah, kemudian nanti ada soalnya. The diagram illustrates the process that is used to manufacture bricks for the building industry. Summarize the information by selecting and reporting the main features and make comparisons where relevant. Jadi nanti dikasih gambar, kemudian ada keterangan dari gambarnya. Oh, the diagram, yo. And then it illustrates the process of manufacturing bricks. Jadi gambar ini nunjukin manufaktur dari batu bata di industri. Nah, so what you're gonna need to write in your writing for the explanation text is all about this process. Jadi kalian gambarin nih prosesnya. Now let's take a look at the sample. Kita lihat sampelnya. Oops. Dia jelasin apa aja. Look at the first paragraph. Ini muncul-muncul terus ya. Yeah, I can move it down here. Wait a second, ya. Oh yeah, I think I can move it here. Yes, oh here. Yeah, here is better. Okay, now look at the first, the writing. The sample of the writing. Ada 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So let's say there are 5 paragraphs written. Kita analisis ya paragrafnya. Let's take a look at the first paragraph. The diagram explains the way in which bricks are made for the building industry. Nah, this first sentence, dia jelasin apa? First sentence, di kalimat pertamanya, nak, dia jelasin apa? The diagram explains the way in which bricks are made for the building industry. Hmm? Look, jadi yang pertama
description.
Ya, yeah, description.
Description of the picture, sir.
Cool. Jadi yang pertama di kalimat pertama dia jelasin deskripsi secara umum gambarnya tentang apa. Let's call me. So, well, if you can make it, I mean, if you are in the examination later on, people usually call it as the paraphrasing. Jadi, nanti di soalnya kan ada ini, keterangan. Yang ini kan, the diagram illustrates the process. Saya bisa ini nggak sih? Wait, bentar ya. Ini, oke ini. Dan di sini. Oke, nanti kan ini ada ini.
Aku yang ngajar.
No, go. Nah, ini kan nanti ada apa namanya soalnya. The diagram illustrates the process that is used to manufacture bricks for the building industry. Keterangan gambarnya. This is what you gonna need to read to write in your writing Jadi ini namanya di paraphrase. Paraphrase itu diganti inti dari inti kalimatnya sama, tetapi katanya diganti. Lihat, the diagram, this is how about the diagram. Illustrates digantinya menjadi kata explains, because basically those are just the same, right? I mean, synonym ya. The process, dia gantinya the way. You see that one? That is used to manufacture bricks for the building industry. Digantinya menjadi in which bricks are made. Nah, jadi di sini dia pakai ini apa? Passive voice, right? In which bricks are made for the building industry. So it's basically has the same message, tapi diparaphrase, diganti susunan kalimatnya, sense-nya. Dapat ya, nak? So that's what you're gonna need to write for the very first sentence of your paragraph. It's like the description of what is the picture about, what is the chart about, gitu. Okay? And then the next sentence in your first paragraph, overall, there are 7 stages in the process, beginning with the digging up of clay and culminating in delivery. Nah, berarti di second paragraph dia menjelaskan apa? The whole stage. Jadi di paragraf pertama, what you need to show is that, dari contohnya yang ini, yang dia tulis adalah, first, he shows what is the picture about, what is the chart about. The second, he shows about the stages. Ada berapa stage? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Ada 7 stage. Dan dia jelasin apa aja stage. Gitu. Mulai dari awalnya apa, sampai yang terakhir adalah delivery, for example. So, that's the only thing that you need to write in your first paragraph. Only 2 sentences. And that's enough. Okay? Let's move on to the second paragraph. To begin, the clay used to make the bricks is dug up from the ground by a large digger. This clay is then placed onto a metal grid, which is used to break up the clay into smaller pieces. A roller assists in the process. Okay, take a look at the sentence. To begin, the clay used to make the bricks is dug from the ground by a large digger. Yang mana prosesnya? Proses pertama kan? Yang ini. Jadi proses di gambar pertama, dia buat di kalimat, di paragraf kedua, di kalimat pertamanya. Oh, ada proses penggalian, digger, dia jelasin. And then this clay is then placed onto a metal grid, which is used to break up the clay into smaller pieces. A roller assists in the process. Nah, and then goes to the next stage. Jadi step pertama dan step kedua, itu dijelasin di paragraf yang keduanya. And then we go to the second, to the third paragraph, paragraf ketiga. Following this, sand and water are added to the clay. And this mixture is turned into bricks by either placing it into a mold or using a wire cutter. Nah, yang ini dia jelasin proses yang ketiga. Ada penambahan sand water, kemudian ada di mold dan di cut bricks-nya dengan wire cutter. And then next, these bricks are placed in an oven to bake for 24 to 48 hours. Dia jelasin yang keempat, yang ini. Nah, so take a look at that. Jadi, di paragraf kedua, in the second paragraph, it talks about the first and the second stage of the process. In the third paragraph, the writer talks about the third and the fourth. Third, fourth process, stage of the process. And then, paragraph keempat, in the subsequent stage, the bricks go through a heating and cooling process. Oh, ini dulu. Tadi yang drying over, 24-48 jam, kemudian di heating, dipanasin di sini. They are heated in a kiln at a moderate and then a high temperature, ranging from 200 to 200 sampai to 1300 degrees Celsius, followed by a cooling process in chamber. For cooling processnya 48 sampai 72 jam, digantinya menjadi 2 to 3 days. So, jadi di paragraf kedua, ketiga, dan keempat, dia masih jelasin stages-nya. And then the last is finally as the conclusion. The bricks are packed and delivered to the destination. You see that's you see how is the writer trying to write or to present the ideas by interpreting or describing the process. Jadi dia mulai dari awal jelasin tentang sekali lagi dari awal dia jelasin tentang secara over gambaran ini tentang apa, kemudian secara overall ada berapa stage yang mau dijelasin, kemudian paragraf selanjutnya adalah mengenai stage-nya, penjelasan tentang stage. Very simple explanation. You can just use one or two or three sentences to describe the process. Terus guna banyak menggunakan kalimat dengan passive voice di sini. Ya. Ini udah dipelajarin passive voice kelas, passive voice udah dipelajarin kelas 11. Ya, yang contoh passive voice-nya itu ada yang ini. The bricks is dig up. And then display is placed, and then the mixture is turned, the water are added. Rata-rata passive voice semua. So it's really related to what you have learned in your previous classes, then to what you're gonna need for writing process. Okay, clear. Nah, so this is the tips and tricks on how you write the writing. So first you need to understand the process. Jadi harus tahu dulu prosesnya itu seperti apa. Where does the process start and end? Jadi dari awal sampai akhirnya harus tahu prosesnya. And then you have to check how many stages are there. And then is it a man-made process or natural process? Why do you need this? You can add this information, whether it's a man-made process or natural process in your writing. Jadi ini bisa ditambahkan kalimatnya. Kalau ini adalah proses natural, ini adalah man-made process, whatever. You can write, you can add. If you think it's necessary to add in your writing. Kayak gitu. And then, is it a silical or linear process? You know what's the difference between silical and linear? This is the different. This one is the silical. Okay, this one is silical and this one is the linear process. Yeah. And then materialsnya apa aja yang perlu ditambahin pada saat prosesnya? And then what is produced? What does each stage of the process do? What are the relationship between each stage? So you need to know this. Ini harus di notice dulu sebelum kalian mulai untuk buat writing-nya. So you need to understand the process, the whole process based on the information and based on the picture you see, you have. Itu. Nah, kemudian you can start writing the overview of the process. Nah, so what is the overview? The general overview is summarizing what's going on in the paragraph. Jadi, dia nunjukin sebenarnya paragraf ini tentang apa sih? Yang kayak tadi di contohnya dijelasin tentang stage-nya ada berapa, kemudian produce-nya apa. That's all enough. Untuk yang di kalimat keduanya, kalau masih ingat tadi, di paragraf yang pertama, introduction. Pertama tentang, kasih tahu gambar tentang apa, kemudian paragraf keduanya, kalian bisa jelasin tentang overview process-nya. Ini tentang apa, ada berapa proses, ada berapa stage. Kayak gitu. Nah, and then, baru masuk ke each stage of the process. Then you can put this in the next paragraph, paragraf kedua, ketiga, dan seterusnya. You can say what each stage does, what is produced, what it produces, I mean, if any materials are added, what are they? And then you can discuss the relationship with the previous or subsequent stages. Jadi bisa dikasih tahu prosesnya seperti apa, hubungannya apa, apa aja yang dibutuhkan, kayak gitu. Next, sequencing the process. These are needed in your writing. Connectors atau connectors are very needed in your writing. Jadi biar jelas. Ini ada yang mengenai perbandingan. What is that? Sorry. Contrast and concession. Ada mengenai sequencing. Ada mengenai cause and effect. You've learned some. Kayak misalnya concession atau contrast. Kalian kan sudah belajar tentang however, nevertheless. Kemudian juga belajar tentang although, even though, and stuff. Then you can just use them in your writing. It's gonna be good if you put those connectors in your writing. Why? Because it gives you points for it. Jadi biar kelihatan tulisannya akan lebih professional, I would say so. Itu akan lebih baik tulisannya dengan penambahan connectors-nya tadi. You also, it depends on which connectors you need, ya. Ada yang sifatnya sequencing. Jadi dia pakai urutan. Firstly, first of all, secondly, after that, dan segala macam. Or you can have penambahan addition, misalnya kayak furthermore, moreover, dan sebagainya. Atau yang cause and effect, kayak therefore, because of, gitu, whereas, dan sebagainya. Banyak. Okay. This also needed. Ada using additional information. Nah, sometimes you also can write or can put your ideas, your additional information in the diagram in your writing. But you can put it if you think that the stage lacks of information for description. Jadi kalau misalnya emang kira-kira perlu penambahan informasi karena menurut kalian emang tidak mencukupi writing yang kalian buat, tulisan yang kalian buat tidak mencukupi syarat jumlah kata yang diminta. Tadi mintanya misalnya 200 kata dan you only can provide like 150 words misalnya setelah kalian buat writing-nya. And then you can add the information, your additional information di situ. Biar mencapai 250 kata tadi. Kayak gitu. Nah, this is another example. Ya, sekarang gantian. Saya mau coba kalian yang waktu kita sudah. Itu masih ada 3 menit lagi ya. Nah, ini adalah contoh. This is the example of, you know, how electricity is generated by a hydroelectric dam. 150 kata. Okay. This is the sample, dude. Coba, di paragraf pertama, dia jelasin apa. It's your turn. Come on, nak. Coba. Anyone? Nanti sama-sama kita iniin. So, this is your turn to tell me. Coba kalian yang analisis ini, dia buat apa di paragraf pertamanya? The diagram illustrates the basic principles of hydroelectric power. Ini tadi apa? Remember? So this one is this ya. Penjelasan tentang gambarnya tadi. Dia menggunakan paraphrasing di sini. Still, dia masih pakai paraphrasing. The diagram illustrates. Di sini shows, diganti jadi illustrates. How electricity is generated by a hydroelectric dam. Di sini dia menyederhanakan menjadi the basic principles of hydroelectric power. Kayak gitu. The second sentence. The process requires the construction of a large dam connected to a powerhouse. Nah, dia jelasin bahwa ini prosesnya itu proses apa? Ada proses konstruksi yang besar dam dan powerhouse-nya. Dia jelasin itu. The dam creates a large reservoir and the powerhouse is where the electricity is generated. Nah, this is another one. Di sini dia menjelaskan tentang secara overall ini gambarnya tentang apa prosesnya kayak gitu. And then the first paragraph to the I think this is the first paragraph dia jelasin juga tentang prosesnya seperti apa, the stages-nya. And then this is also about the process and the conclusion sedikit. Nah, ini yang tadi dibilang dikatakan bahwa perlu ada information, additional information. It is interesting to note that hydroelectric dam creates no harmful byproducts and relies entirely on natural forces to produce electricity. Nah, ini kan nggak ada di gambarnya. And you can add this. Ini dianggap sebagai additional information. And this is still okay as long as it is related to the picture or to the cycle you have. It's gonna be okay as long as it is related and it helps. It explain the explanation in your writing. Kayak gitu. Alright, this is also the example in which you can check. Yeah, I think that's all. Nanti akan saya kirim satu gambar, mungkin bisa coba ditulis ya nak. What you gonna need to write about this, guys, untuk latihan doang. And you can submit it later on. Oh yeah, so jangan lupa juga submit tugas writing yang kemarin. And then for next week, as I promised you, we're going to talk about the TOEFL karena materinya sudah selesai. Untuk materi kalian semuanya sudah selesai. So we go to the enrichment. So for the enrichment is about the TOEFL. We're going to talk about the TOEFL. Modulnya juga sudah saya kirim. Jadi sistemnya adalah kita buat per. Nanti kalian bahas di rumah per chapternya. Kalau nggak salah yang pertama itu tentang subject and verb. Oh, tentang verb saya kalau nggak salah. Then you do it at home, dikerjakan di rumah. Nanti next week we're going to discuss seperti apa. I'm not going to tell you about very basic grammar and structure, tapi secara saya akan jelasin grammar dan structure-nya berdasarkan soal yang muncul. Oke? Okay? Well, I think that's all for today. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you.
Okay.